And I only have like
19, but I'm using like 15 of them, so.
At the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Oakland Raiders and the Dallas Cowboys. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
Right through a guy. Wow.
Some of these people haven't
even taken their seat. Oh shit. It's commonly known as a fast start. That's what my horse
Jesus Christ.
They caught a flyer.
This is disgusting.
And guess what? They're in the lead now.
I'm dead.
Out to kick is Janikowski.
God damn, you got a fucking...
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20.
Oh.
Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Oh. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three. A second down throw for Prescott.
Bad pass.
Drops it underneath to Elliott. And they get him down, but not before he takes
oh my god, I can't believe that really happened first play. That was disgusting.
First down carry by Elliott. And he'll be taken down, but not
what were the odds of that?
Enemy territory. 10 more there and another first down. Elliott last year is so darn good, over 1,600 yards, most in the NFL. Actually, there were 10 teams that didn't rush for as many yards as he did. That's how good he was.
And just think, there is a place for him to get better. And I think it's in pass receiving, not necessarily the hands, but just throwing it to him more, getting him into open space. He can make even more big plays doing that.
Prescott looks to throw on first.
Oh!
And it's incomplete. The Cowboys' all-time receptions leader, Jason Witten, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. The inaugural carry for Darren McFadden. And some space here. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
So right now what I'm seeing an offense just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks too. I'm seeing guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hint of contact.
They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott.
What the?
Oh no.
9 yards, and it'll be second down. On second down, Elliott. Now a flag comes in from the umpire after a gain of about 4.
Holding?
And this looks like it's going to be holding.
Eh.
suck my dick.
So on the big tight end, Holden.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without Holden.
Check, check 43.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29 yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
No.
On third down, Elliott.
I think it ran right into him.
About the 27. 2 yards on the pick up there.
Oh, that was third down. Oh no. That's wild. I'm still playing it though. I'm fucking.
That didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
Oh, that's really disappointing, actually.
Stay put on the sideline. They're gonna go on fourth down here. Prescott down. Complete to Jason Witten. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. That one good for 12 yards. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. First down, a run with McFadden. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Prescott now on second down.
Oh, get that shit. Catch it.
The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver. And it's third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Who's that? I don't know. I should not have thrown that. That was dumb. He was supposed to go a completely different direction.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And the Cowboys will call on Dan Bailey here.
Oh.
So they get three. They were hoping for six. An unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board. Happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite
what
sideline,
the
though,
the defense high-fiving each other. What the fuck? Giving up three. Whoa.
Run that much offense.
I approve.
I have done like
there will be a few comments muttered. Yeah, you would have got tackled
as they head out on the field.
Now a play fake here on first down.
Oh.
And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys.
Wow.
Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love those short throws come and those eyes get
oh, this is a miss. Holy fuck. That was horrible. Wow.
Take it in the opposite direction.
I'm dead. He just scored.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. No, a nifty juke there.
Not much time for a guy trying to tackle him.
That's pretty racist.
And now here come the Raiders.
Double tight, guys, double tight.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together.
Express. Gears. 618.
Jim.
93. Get set.
Now Carr to try again after the pick six. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Following the interception, here's Prescott. Complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. First down, Prescott.
Oh my.
And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
5 yards left for the offense. It's second down.
Watch left, watch left. It's our time.
Here we go.
It's
19. 26. 55. Mike 55. 26. 26.
Out of the gun, here's Prescott.
Oh, twirly! Oh my god. Wow. That's disgusting.
If you would have threw it later, you would have sacked.
Wow. I'm tight. The fuck is this?
Takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. Call it a gain of 7 against
Oh yeah, because Elliott is freaking suspended right now. So he was? Hold up. Why are they making this nigga run then? Fuck that. Got this bozo playing. So yeah, whatever.
Boy, they were
successful. Oh god, I forgot my play. What was I even doing?
Oh, you catch that?
For a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. Job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up. Getting the sense, Charles, are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not?
Charles Davis, and Gordon, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number 2, and they're driving, but they come up on a 3rd and short here.
No. Did I flip the run? Oh, that was, wow. Not what I thought was about to happen.
I have to admit, a little bit of surprise on that play call. Short yardage, and they tried to go wide. They got spilled for their efforts.
This offense converted once on 4th down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. Flush to his right. He can run.
What the?
No! Fumbled the ball!
Yes.
The Cowboys are unable to convert on 4th down, and that will force a turnover on downs. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the
other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
And he's going to lose yardage back to his own 1 yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, I know it does get the end. God damn, 47.
Taught is catch the football, don't drop it,
but drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
On second down, Lynch, and he'll get him a little space here up to the 5 yard line. Give him 4 on the carry there, but that only takes him back to where they started. 3rd and 10.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on 3rd down.
What?
And he will take this up to about the
wow. They do that a lot. They run into their own people a lot, really annoying.
There was a hole right there.
On the side of their helmets, rising up on defense. We always hear about the Cowboys' rushing offense. Their rush defense is pretty good as well, I think, because they're so cohesive. Defensive line, linebackers really work well together.
Pressure comes, but it doesn't prevent him from getting off a good one here. Fair catch taken just inside the 40-yard line. 51 yards on the punt there.
That's not a flag.
The Cowboys will take over with a 1st and 10. The Raider defense now, here they are as they get ready to trot back onto the field. Last time, pretty big moment in the game. Deciding to pass on the field goal, they went for it.
And
it's always interesting to watch, too, to watch both sides. Are we going to go for it on offense? The defense waiting to see which unit they need to have on the field.
No!
Kick the field goal or not. And once you realize they're going to go for it, to watch the defense now kind of mount a little extra energy to try and stop them, and when they're successful, well, the emotion just really kind of stick. A little bit more than that.
And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They wanted it every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. On 2nd down, McFadden. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down to 49. It's a gain of maybe 3, but it's going to leave them with about 8 or 9 to go on 3rd down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. The Cowboys on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 9. 2 minutes to play here in the 1st half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this 1st half of action. On 3rd down, it's Prescott.
No way.
And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the 1st. And an alley to run. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Darren McFadden, 29 yards. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Bailey now to kick this one away.
Oh, shit.
That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Derek Carr getting set and ready to go again on offense here. He and his team, they have had a rough go of it here in this first half. Maybe time for him to put his foot down here in the second quarter.
Put his foot down and become a little more accurate throwing the football. He's already thrown two interceptions. He's trying to find a way to equal things out. And instead of it going to the opponents, get it to his own receivers and find the end zone.
Yeah, you mentioned those two picks. No touchdown passes yet either. A gain of three, second down.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so they can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down. On second down, here's Carr. He'll dump it off complete to Lynch.
That day.
Go down just shy of the 24 at the 24-yard line. It's a gain of six on the play, and that'll bring up a third and one.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
They'll run it. Here's
Lynch. Oh.
Close to the 25-yard line. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
There are times when I think people just overlook how good a player Sean Lee really is. One of the more athletic linebackers in the league. He can make plays against the run. You name it, he's one of the better ones out there.
And number 50, so loved by the fans in Dallas.
Oh, he still held that?
Okay,
one more clock.
Down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. First down, the run with Lynch.
Come on!
And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. The final shot here before half for Carr. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play.
Uh-oh.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Here comes Ryan Switzer to return it.
Oh, shit.
A good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. The numbers for Dak as a rookie last year are still kind of mind-boggling. And you look at QB rating. Dak was 104.9. Now, among full-time quarterbacks, only two Super Bowl quarterbacks, Matt Ryan and Tom Brady, were higher.
And look who he finished ahead of. Guys like Aaron Rodgers, Drew Brees, Russell Wilson. Amazing.
Single slot. Single slot. On first and 10, Prescott.
Damn, that O-line is crazy.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble. Second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all this long they kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Oh my God. I don't like that. Nope, don't do that. Oh, shit.
Now Prescott.
Nope, yep, and so saw that coming. Such a bad pass.
Had an interception return for a touchdown last year, another one there. What's the goal for a defensive back? One a season?
One a season is really fantastic. Way more than you would expect.
Let's go.
Guys set those types of goals, but rarely are they reached, rarely they achieve. To be able to pull it off back-to-back seasons, who says no one makes house calls anymore?
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right? Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and test the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
They go to Elliott again. And now running right through him. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Prescott on first down. He's got the connection to Cole Beasley. Touchdown, Cowboys! Cole Beasley, 60 yards. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
So they only needed three plays on that drive. And it culminates in a Dallas touchdown.
And we only need one.
Bailey now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And a big hit there as it runs into a brick wall at the 12-yard line.
Well, conventional football, 101 tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams...
Okay, no more stupid plays.
Try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
It's hauled in by Lee Smith. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Shipped together here from the D-line. Play action. Now it's Carr. To the sideline, and it's caught, but boy, he's out of bounds.
What the fuck?
Him into space, can the backfield, and it'll be third down.
This nigga's a beast.
remember. Oh my
job, bro.
I was going to say he likes to get the ball handed to him. Now, don't get me wrong, he's good at passing game as well, but maybe a little out of his comfort zone. Yeah, he might want to have a few words.
Oh yeah.
He's going to fall on the floor. What the fuck? Marshawn Lynch is too beast. He's getting me tight.
This thing of gold. What the fuck, him?
Well, if we had any questions, that run kind of answered.
Been another fucking Marshawn Lynch.
No. Running with a renewed sense
of purpose and energy after that year off. They go play action here on first down.
Look, you got another job, bro.
They dump it off to Lynch. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and it's a second down.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. As Ike learned to ballet school, got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
Throw left side to the tight end, Walford. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one will go as a gain of 11. Raiders having a first down as well.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Hey, Raider 2. Here we go. Express.
Four down. Check.
On first down, Carr. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
Holding. Nice.
Oh my god.
Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, the march up another 15 against your squad.
They'll roll him out right. And now the ball's
what?
Can I quit?
All the receivers in their patterns.
I can quit. I can quit for you.
Oh my God.
In this case, never even had a chance. They popped the ball free in the backfield.
Oh, fuck.
No!
Get off me!
To about the 38.
That was bullshit.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
So second and medium, second and five.
Oh my God. Second and medium, second and he's nuts.
And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They
No. Oh, shit.
I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
It's the Cowboys with the football. They'll be looking to tack onto their lead as we get set for the fourth. The Cowboys on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. Looking to throw, Prescott.
Get him.
That was real bad. In there to make the play, it'll be a loss.
That shit, bitch.
He's
trying to do everything that he's been taught.
Fuck that.
But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
They'll need to get the play off quickly. There's
Prescott. And he dropped it.
Complete.
It looked like he had it, and
It wouldn't matter, I didn't pass the first down line. I'm gonna kill myself. What the mindset was to go for it. I don't know. And some teachers feel like possession is the key to everything. They just want to have the football in their hands. No matter how it goes to the other team, they just don't trust doing that. So they say, listen, go for it and try and finish it ourselves. Intended that time for Cooper. That'll bring up second down. This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it. They got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes.
Goddamn, boy, you suck. 72, you sucky, sucky. No fucking sucky. You're the stink. How did you let him go right by you? Due in large part to a good O-line,
Carr was sacked on less than 3% of his lowest in the league.
Oakland knew it was important to take care of the quarterback. They picked up Donald Penn, Kelechi Osemele, and Rodney Hudson in recent years, and it's paid off. Make this. Once again, a
good example of situational football. That was third and very long, so you know they were guarding against the pass. And when they decided to run the ball, that was okay.
Damn it.
Picked up, as long as they didn't get to the first down marker,
you made that?
The defense was willing to let's concede, go. And they stopped
right,
them
get
well
the
short
stop.
Of a first down.
Right,
they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal then maybe not exactly what they wanted. Oh, this is annoying. First step. Still plenty of time remaining, but damn. You can really use a stop defensively after the kickoff, preferably a three and out. Block him. Be taken in the end zone. Please. Thank you.
And he gets what? What the?
The huh?
Please, Matt. Yard line. Holding. Flag down. This could
set him back. Gotta be fucking kidding me. Watch this bullshit. Yep.
Hey, loves
sucking me off. Yeah, this is gonna put him back with a not
great field position. So they really let's do that, baby. Yeah, baby. Position, as you pointed out, not in this case. Get this bitch. As he gets this one up to about the 23. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Yeah, we got him.
Take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down. Now whistles and the Rams have a signal for a timeout. It's just their first of the game, the two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The battle in the trenches never more important than right now. This is
oh, crap.
Maybe I shouldn't have done this. Shit.
Wow. Holding.
What is this nigga doing? Hold on. Whoa, whoa. Yo. They look sucking me off. They can't just let me
in a butt shot, bro.
Bro, don't talk about that.
Yes!
I think that's a big time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick, but able to see
you're right.
Diagnose it,
I should.
The football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
I should, right? I really should. But I don't want to, though. But I really should.
And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. The Cowboys will go. Prescott. Complete. Jason Williams. 7 yards on the pickup. And it'll be first down, Cowboys.
Yo, I like that. In surprise, going for it on fourth, I like that.
Let's go to the game, though. Let's look at the game like a genius.
So the next time we see Coach, he's gonna say, well, that's why I coached, and that's why he got stopped up there, right? He had the guts to go ahead and go for it, and it paid off.
Able to shake free for about seven up to the 35. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
Is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Yo. Gotta get them aggressive catches.
You better just do it.
Possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock.
There we go. Wide eight.
Hey, guys, check me out. Check me out. Three down. We got to stand up. Our
first down throw for Prescott. Yeah. 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 No.
Snags it for the pick, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Oh, my.
Take the
That's
field.
Gonna pick six. Come on, bitch, hurry up.
The kickers in today's game are so good,
wow,
so skilled, and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They gotta feel good about that. And they better make sure they wrap him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see.
Oh my. Oh my.
Where did this nigga come from?
And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line.
Oh my God.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down to the hands of the wrong team.
Oh, I got stuck on my own guy. Are you serious? Oh, that's hilarious. Mean, stupid.
Every year I go to the combine, I'm marveled.
Jesus Christ.
Linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's see if they know the finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Strong right.
Hey, pick your game up.
Right in.
Wow, you're not that ass.
Incomplete. Watch.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Wow, that's wild.
Let's go.
That's disgusting.
Lacking much success, just
2%. He really did, like, that's crazy.
Got him.
Got a man over the middle. It's Williams.
Check.
Terrence Williams.
Oh,
and he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Now rush.
No!
Incomplete.
I'm dead.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit.
That's gonna work.
I liked it when they would fake it from the 3 yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and he's gonna get two. That's great. But from the 15, the risk reward, it's just not there.
It's so risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippers.
I bet the kicker doesn't have a.
Let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
And now Oakland ready to take the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Oh, my God. Pass interference?
And Cook has it left side.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them a first down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking left side, he's got a man. That's Cook. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. Fresh set of downs here. They fake the handoff. Now Carr. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown in. Frankly, that should have been another pick right there. And he's brought down. And now we're going to get a timeout. Somewhat pointlessly called with 3 seconds to go in a game that's already been decided. And this looks to probably be the final play. One final try now for Carr. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And, oh, a little spin cycle. Room to run now. And he will score. Touchdown.
GG? Oh, shit, so I was done.
Now the final act of this victory, the extra point. Throwing after the interception.
No.
Rush.
No.
And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the...